Hi, this is Andy from Happy Mama Homeschool, and today I am doing the Homemaker Tag. I've seen a few of my favorite YouTubers do this tag, and I thought it would be kind of fun, so let's give it a try. The first question is, have you ever had anyone say anything negative to you about staying at home? And I do not recall anybody ever saying anything negative to me about staying at home. I am usually met with encouragement and support. Number two, what is your favorite and least favorite part of staying home? I would have to say that my favorite part about staying at home is being with my kids 24/7. No rest for the weary. I love it. And I cannot get enough of just the idea that wherever I am, they are. And wherever I am, they are. And wherever I am, they are. I mean, how wonderful is that? In all seriousness, my kids are my favorite part about being at home and being able to spend time with them. Seeing the milestones, you know, seeing the accomplishments when that light goes on in their head about something and they finally understand it. And I love watching them play together. And it reminds me to lighten up. You know, as adults, for myself anyway, I've become, I don't know, more of a stick in the mud as I've gotten older. And they remind me how to be kids and how to enjoy even the simplest of things. So that's my favorite part. My least favorite part is probably, I found this one hard to think of. When I was first a new mom 5 years ago, it was really hard, the no adult interaction and nobody else to talk to. And it really just feeling like you were alone. But now that I have a 5-year-old and a 3-year-old and a 1-year-old, I have definitely more conversations throughout my day with the older kids. It's not obviously the same as talking to your girlfriends or other adults, but at least it doesn't feel like you're literally talking to nobody or this, you know, blob that just stares back at you. Another thing I really miss is a paycheck. I know that I am being paid with blessings and joys that a monetary amount cannot even come close to comparing to, but I do miss a paycheck. Next question is, what is your favorite and least favorite chore? My favorite chore is probably vacuuming. I got a new vacuum cleaner for Christmas and it's a cordless one. And I love it. It's a Dyson stick vacuum, I think it's called. But it is so nice to be able to run that thing through the house without having to plug it in. I basically like cleaning anything that is really, really dirty because then it proves that you did something. What do I not like doing? I really don't like ironing and I do not clean the tub or the shower. I leave those up to my husband. For some reason, I really just don't like doing them. So, what time do you wake up and go to bed? So for the last year, I had gone through having a newborn, and he just turned 1 year old, and he just started sleeping through the night. Now that he is starting to sleep through the night, if I have a good night where he doesn't get up, I will try to get up between 5 and 6 in the morning. I love having that morning time, and it's time that I can spend, you know, reading or doing what I need to do. I can't really do housework. We don't have a huge house. The kids would wake up and that would just not be what I want to be doing with my morning time, is spending time with the kids. I need that time for me. And so I can be happy mama when they get up and I can, if they're cranky, then we're not all cranky together. So I like to get up pretty early and then going to bed. If I'm being consistent with getting up early, then I usually go to sleep between 9 and 10. Do you put anything on in the background when you do your cleaning and your cooking? Yeah, I found this great Pandora station. It's called Children Screaming at the Top of Their Lungs. And I just put it on like replay and the highest volume I possibly can. I do like putting on music, but usually my kids have music playing in the living room and that's totally fine. I'll just listen to whatever they're listening to. I love podcasts, but I have learned that I cannot usually listen to them on a speaker. Like, it's better to have it in my earbuds, because actually even then sometimes it's hard. Because when my kids start coming around, running around, and I'm trying to listen to the podcaster talk about how not to yell at your kids, and then I start screaming at my kids because I can't hear what she's saying about not yelling at my kids, doesn't really work out so well. So that doesn't really happen anymore. The next question is, do you get dressed every single day or stay in your PJs? I get dressed every day. I don't get dressed up every day, but I get dressed. We usually will go somewhere. Now, when I just had my one child or maybe even two kids, I would stay in my pajamas more, but I get really lazy and super unproductive when I'm not dressed. So I try to get dressed every single day. How often do you do your hair and makeup? So I don't know exactly what do my hair means, because it gets brushed like every 1 to 3 days, and it gets thrown up in this messy bun or in a ponytail or in a braid. I do not know the first thing about styling hair, as you can obviously tell. All of this here, this is all postpartum. It went all the way around. It all came out, and this is the regrowth. So, this is what you get. You come into my door at 9 in the morning, this is already what I look like. So, yeah, I'm sorry. And makeup, I don't wear makeup. I own makeup, and maybe I'll wear it like once a month. Maybe if I'm going out with my husband. Styling my hair or doing makeup has never been a part of my life. And now that I'm in my 30s, I still don't know what I'm doing, and it seems like a lot of work. So, I don't do it. What is your trouble zone or area in your home that needs the most help? I have a counter in my kitchen. I don't have any junk rooms, no junk closets, but I have a junk counter, and that's the counter in my kitchen. And it drives me crazy that it's always cluttered with random toys, socks, flashlights, like pens, papers, the junk mail, this anything super random you can find on my kitchen counter. How often do you find yourself getting distracted? I am distracted all the time. All the time. I am in the middle of doing one thing and I see something else that needs to be done, so I stop this thing and go over to that thing. I'm constantly trying to see, you know, like how much I can get done, how productive I can be. My kids are calling for me, hey mom, come here, come look at this. I am trying to find every single little thing along the way that I can do before I get to them. You know, oh, 1 minute and let me do that. Just one more and let me just do that. All the time. And then when I am sitting down with them, all I think about are the things that I need to get done, the things that are on my list, my mental list, or my written list that need to get done. And I have to tell myself, okay, you will sit here for 20 minutes. You will not get up until 20 minutes has passed and you have read these two books to the kids and just focus on being with them, because I am distracted all the time. Okay, the next question is asking if I miss going to work every day or if I enjoy staying at home. I love staying at home. Besides, like I said, the paycheck and some of the interaction with people. I worked at a doctor's office and got to know patients. So that was a lot of fun, getting to know different people and just the great people that I worked with. But I would not take that again over what I have now, being at home. I absolutely love being at home. And another thing I think too is that I never found a career that I was passionate about. I never found something that really, really I wanted to stick with doing for the rest of my life. So maybe if I had, I would miss it more, but what I have now is far greater. What is your never-ending chore? Laundry and dishes, which I feel like is pretty self-explanatory. Way to relax and have me time. Me time. Me? Like me time? Me. Target? Yeah, walking the aisles of Target. Me time. I need to discover this this year. This should be one of my goals. Figure out what I love to do for me time. How often does your husband chip in? He usually helps me out, especially in the kitchen, on the weekends when he's not working. Otherwise, he has a full work week. Plus, he's got evenings where he's trying to start his own business. So he's pretty busy with that. And I'm totally fine with that. I feel like I can handle pretty much everything else on my own. He does do big things, like if I'm gone for the weekend with the kids out of town, he will mop the whole house or like paint. He's painted a few walls before while I was gone. So big things like that that I really don't want to do, he does do them. And I am so appreciative of that. If you have kids, when do you find time to do chores? I'm doing chores, I feel like, all day long. The kids are really good at playing with each other. And there's quite a bit of time in the day that they don't need me or aren't bothering me. And I can get some stuff done. And really, if I just buckle down and do things, it takes a lot less time than I think it's going to. So yeah, just whenever I can. How do you balance being a homemaker and creating YouTube content? I am brand new to YouTube, so I don't have the answer to this. I don't really know. Two of my kids right now are napping, and the other one is standing in front of me, bouncing his head on the bed. So, here we are.
I didn't know that.
because I can see you. What is your favorite room in your home and why? I really like my bedroom. I don't really spend a lot of time in my bedroom. I like the color of it and I like the furniture that we have in it. What is your least favorite room in your house and why? I wish we had a laundry room. So I have a laundry closet. Maybe I could say that would be my least favorite area. It'd be nice if we had an actual room. At least it's not in the garage. I feel bad for people who have it in the garage. That would feel like such a dread. Do you feel your home reflects your personal style? Why or why not? So I used to have my walls like super decorated with pictures. I did photography before I had kids. I had lots of trinkets and ornaments all over the place. After I had my first kid, I went really bonkers. And then after my second one, I discovered minimalism and was like, I need this. So I got rid of a ton of stuff, including a lot of stuff off my walls. So now there's not much in the area of decorations. Does my home reflect my personal style? It would be blah, is how I describe that. I don't know anything about style either, so I guess it's just minimalist style. I'm not like super, super minimalist, but yeah, I'm sorry. This question, I'm having a hard time answering it. Obviously, I'm stumbling all over my words. And one day, you know, I hope to have more decorations and I don't know, more of that kind of stuff, but it's just not now. That's just not my time right now. I see other people's houses and it looks so cute, but then I come home and I'm overwhelmed with what I have. And what does your home smell like? I don't know, but we got, you know, diapers and poop here. I'm hoping it don't smell like that. I like to do candles and essential oil, so hopefully it smells good. No one's ever told me it stunk, except when you go in the kids' room and the diaper pails a little full. What is your strong point and weak spot when it comes to homemaking? So I would probably say that my strong point is that I get things done, but my weak spot is that I spend a lot of time getting this place ship shape, and it takes away time from family and it takes away time from what is most and more important to me. But it's really hard. The perfectionist in me wants it all done all the time. And so that would definitely have to be my weak spot. Anyway, I hope that this gives you a little glance into my life as a homemaker. If you have any questions, leave them down below. If you want to do this tag, that'd be great. Let me know and I'll watch your video as well. Take care.